Hi, my name's Andy Morrison, and I'm one of the instructors with the Rapid Training Group and Rapid Tracks. And I'm here today to just for the people that are novice riders in terms of track days, just to give you a couple of tips on what you should be thinking about before you come on a track day. And once you're at the track day, some of the things that go on, which might worry you a little bit, and but of course there's no need to. One of the first things that I might advise and just get you to think about is actually not at the track day itself. Is before you actually think of coming to a track day, get everything prepared. You'll need the paperwork for the bike, for instance, your driving license and so on, and you'll need the bike to be in good order. So make sure those sort of things are settled and you've got everything planned before you actually come for the track day. Certainly, if you come to any of the MSV events, the first thing they're going to ask for is your driving license. And if you turn up without your driving license, that could be a bit of a problem. So, like documentation, which is really important, and the plans before you come to the track day. The most essential thing, really, is to make sure this, your motorcycle that you're actually bringing to the track day, is in really good order. For those riders that are not particularly good mechanically, get the thing serviced before you actually come along on the day. Track days are notoriously hard on bikes in two main areas. The first one is the tyres, and if you're a reasonably quick rider, the tyres will take quite a pounding. Chains, another thing. And when you come to, particularly with a rapid tracks day, we'll have a look at the bike for you to make sure that the bike's quite serviceable before you go out on the track. And the thing that crops up time and time again are just simple little things with the bike, which could be easily rectified before you actually come to the event anyway. Tight chains. Very loose chains. Today, for instance, there's probably 120 riders here. And out of that, there are half a dozen riders which had just a problem with the chain. The other thing which is quite hard, which track days tend to be very, very hard on, are naturally brakes. And if you're not mechanically minded, get somebody to look at it for you who is. As I say, probably the best thing is just send it in for a service and let them know you're doing a track day. But again, time and time again, we'll get people turning up for a track day, and you have a look at the brakes, and the brakes are worn out. We will not let you out on the bike unless out onto the track on the bike, unless your bike is basically roadworthy and suitable to take out onto the track. Tyres, very important bit of equipment, and that's all that's between you and the road. It's really important. We don't really want to talk about falling off a motorbike. When you come to a track day, and when you ride two wheels, you might at some stage fall off. You should accept the fact that you might fall off. You don't want to fall off, but just accept the fact that you might. Now, historically, if you look at the people that do crash when they're at track days, a lot of the time, it's because they haven't warmed up the tyres. And the grip of these tyres, this one's absolutely stone cold at the moment. And if I went out onto the track right now, the track surface is also quite cool today. And if I went out now and tried to go very fast, I would be straight into the kiddie litter. If you don't have tyre warmers, which of course most novices attending their track day for the first time won't have, you'll need to do at least 5 or 6 laps before this gets to any temperature at all, where it's going to supply the amount of grip that you really need to take the corners quite quickly. So, important advice, number one, when you go out onto the track, don't try and go too fast straight away. Just build up the speed very, very gradually, be as smooth as you can, and you will need several laps, particularly on a day like today. You'll need several laps before you get any heat in these tyres sufficient to be able to corner quickly. Warm up the tyres. When you arrive at a track day for the first time, there's no doubt the majority of people are really quite nervous. I can assure you now that there really isn't any need to be nervous at all. You're amongst a bunch of other people that are going to be probably just as nervous. We, the instructors, are here to look after you. Now, with the rapid tracks day, in a novice group, you'll certainly get four instructors out. So make use of them. They're there to help you. They're any particular area, whether you just feel nervous about it for the first time or you have a problem once you're out on the track, the instructors are there to help us. It's not just rapid tracks. Companies that you go with, there will be instructors out with the novice group, so make use of them. They're there to help you. When you come to a track for the first time, as a novice or even as an experienced rider, one of the things to try not to do is to actually ride around the circuit quickly to start with. The importance of the correct lines through the corners, the correct speed for the corners, is crucial. And a mistake a lot of people make when they arrive at a circuit for the first time, not necessarily novices, is that they won't watch the instructors to find out what the correct lines are to take specific corners, but they'll try to go too fast, and as a result of that they can't really think about where they should be on the track. They just know they're going very fast, and as a result probably panic themselves. Another very, very common error for most riders is to think about the circuit in terms of where they need to brake. Where is the braking markers for this bend? Here we've got some markers here, 150, 100 yards and so on before we get to the corner. Where do I need to brake? Don't think about where it's possible to brake the latest when you get to a circuit. The most important thing with this circuit is which lines you should be taking through the corner and what the mid-corner speed should be at the apex. And if you work at that to start with and then gradually work back from the bend once you've got the speed right and the line right through the corner. If you do it the other way around, if you try to brake very, very late for the corner, all you'll succeed in doing is just screwing up the corner and maybe going into the kitty litter on the other side of the bend. Slowly to start with, learn the track, get the advice from the instructors on what the correct lines are, and feel comfortable in the corner so you're relaxed. The last part of any track to learn is where you can brake the latest. So there we are, there's some tips for your first track days. If you look around at the moment, we've got probably about 140 people here. We were having a really good time, and that's the whole essence of having a track day. You've got two wheels, you want to use the bike to the best of its ability, the best of your ability, and there's no better place to actually bring it along to a track day. We're really friendly people. Everybody's, as I say, there's 140, 150 very smiling faces around here. So come along, if you've had a little bit of trepidation before, no reason to. Just try and have a really good day with Rapid Tracks and with some of the other companies, and you'll be fine. We look forward to seeing you.